गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स. नाउ आफ्टर लर्निंग दी चौसठ कलास, लेट्स गो अहेड एंड अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आर दी 14 विद्यास एंड हाउ कलास एंड विद्यास आर डिफरेंट. नाउ इन कलास यू हैव सीन दैट दे वर गिविंग अस द विजुअल फीस्ट टू अवर आईज एंड दे वर लॉट ऑफ आर्ट्स इन दैट मैनर इन विच वी वर टू लर्न देम एंड अ सीक्वेंस वॉज गिवन टू अस, राइट? दैट येस यू हैव टू कम्प्लीट विद दिस, देन यू हैव टू प्रोसीड फॉर द सेकेंड. एंड वी हैव सीन दैट इट यू नो सम हाउ एनकैप्सुलेट्स ऑल द एक्टिविटीज ऑफ अवर लाइफ इन अ वेरी नाइस मैनर. द 14 विद्यास, दीज आर द टेक्निक्स एंड यू नो they comprised of the four Vedas, that is the Rig Veda, Sam Ved, Yajur Ved and Athar Veda, and the four Upavedas, that is the abodes of the knowledge like Arthashastra, ancient treaties on statecraft, economic policy, military strategy. Now these Arthashastras, also remember, they are different, written from different perspectives. Like Chanakya Arthashastra is very different, then there are other Arthashastras also. Ravan also had written. So you know, it's up to us that we need to search, find out as to which is the best Arthashastra and then go ahead. Though Chandakya Arthashastra is the most, or the Kautilya Arthashastra, you know, that's the most popular one. Then we have got the Dhanurveda, that is the science of archery. Now all the prince princesses, you know, who were there, they were given the Dhanurvidya also. And if you have seen the movie you know, Bahubali, there, you know, the what's his name, the hero, you know, he is the one who has learned, and that's why what's her name, the other lady who was there, you know, the princess, now she is the one who says that I want to learn the art of, you know, aiming and throwing the arrows using the three fingers and three arrows together. And that's why, you know, he comes and he helps her out. So even if you see all the three movies together, one is the Jodha Akbar, where we have seen the sword fighting between Jodha and Akbar also. Then we have seen Ashoka the Great, wherein Shahrukh Khan and Kareena Kapoor, who was the Kauraviki, the princess, there also we have seen the sword fighting. Then we have seen the sword fighting exclusively in Jhansi Ki Rani, also we have turned up. Then Bajirao Mastani also, you know, had this sword fighting. And finally, you know, there are Padmavat, if you have seen that, she is also a learned lady and she knew how to take care of the weapons also side by side. So you know, Dhanurvidya in that manner, not just the Dhanur, even the sword fighting, horse riding, these were also mandatory. And Sita, if you pick up the book written by Amish Tripathi, you will see that yes, Sita was also given that education. She was never barred, and her father Janak Maharaj, you know, never ever stopped her from learning those skills also. Then we have got the Gandharva Ved, that is a treatise on performing arts encompassing theatre, dance and music. So Gandharva Ved is one side. Then you have got Ragas and Raginis, popular in Shiv Puranas. Then Gandharva Ved for Indralok, we have seen Apsaras and all those people were also present. And if you can grab the copy of the Gandharva Ved, you would be able to understand what kind of rules and regulations have been laid upon for these three things also side by side. Now apart from the four Upavedas, you will see that we have got the other studies also with us. Now for example, if we look about the six Vedangas, now here the six of them have been given to us in a very nice manner. For example, first is the Siksha. Now see, for here I don't know how historically the word Siksha, what was used in the ancient Indian system and what it is used right now are two different things. Siksha in ancient India meant science of phonetics and phonology of Sanskrit. It aims is the teaching of the correct pronunciation of the Vedic hymns and mantras. So you know, a lot of ucharan exercises, you know, you cannot do those MTI issues or errors like sir, sure, sir kind of a thing. So you have to be very careful about how, otherwise you know, there are certain repercussions for them also. Kalpa, the art of rituals, you know, so you have to learn For example, if you read Valmiki's Ramayana, he has made it very clear. If king is going to perform any kind of a ritual or a ceremonial ritual, then if he is married, then his wife should be present. And if he is not married, then he is not eligible for any kind of ritual whatsoever it is taking place in the society. However, look at right now what is happening. So, you know, you can compare both of the things and then look upon it. Vyakaran, like we take about the Sanskrit grammatical tradition, wherein you focus more on the Vyakaran rule, especially the Sanskrit one. Then comes Nirukta, that is the art of etymology, particularly of obscure words. Like if you are taught Sanskrit, the grammar is taught, the etymology is taught, then you know how to come about and create new words and then proceed further with certain things. So here brief rules, that is sutras for deriving word meanings, and then rare Vedic words are all being taken care of. Then Chanda is the nothing but the study of the Vedic meter in classical Sanskrit poetry. So if you are very fond of poetry, then you should know that yes, like in English we have got prose, then the stanzas, the line, the commas, the homonyms, the way they are used. In the same manner, Chanda gives us a good introduction to the Indian poetry. Next comes the Jyotish Shastra, wherein the system of astrology. Now this has been divided into three categories. First of all, it is a Siddhanta, which talks about the Indian astronomical sciences completely, and we have got the complete treatise on it, which really talks about that. Then we have got Samhitas. Now Samhitas, I would say Saptarishis were present. Apart from the Saptarishis, any person who was knowledgeable and who knew the art of astrology and numerology and the tarot cards also, they were able to take care. Now for example, we have got Brihaspati Shastras, we have got Samhitas, then Kaushik Samhitas we have got. Then in the same manner, Kashyap Samhitas are present. So a huge list of those Samhitas are there, and if you pick up, you will see each one of them. So in Indian Hindu system of astrology, you will see that definitely all the Saptarishis were very different, and even Ravan, it was not just confined to those Saptarishis only, let me tell you. Now if you go ahead and start reading the Samhitas, Ravan also gave his own views about the entire Jyotish Shastra. Then the second one that we have got is called as Medini Jyotisha. Like if you go to Kashmir, Kashmir was the headquarters for the Kashmiri Pandits, and there they had really come up. Now if you go the Pari Mahal, there it is, even now it is existing. Now some of them are present in the form of the scriptures, otherwise you can go ahead and you are able to look at them. Then under the Medina Jyotisha, you will see prediction of important events based on the analysis of the astrological dynamics in a country's horoscope, and the events like a war, earthquakes, political. So they have I would say that yes, the complete list of things have been presented out, including Vastu Shastra. That is one more thing which is related to the building structure, how the entrance should be made, where the cooking should be done. All those kind of things have been discussed in these six Vedangas. Now apart from the six Vedangas, you will also see that yes, they are talking about Hora. Hora is what? Predictive astrology. So it is not just the regressive kind of an astrology they were talking about. They were talking about even the predictive astrology, which was based on the analysis of the natal horoscope. And that's why you see in some of the movies, wherever the king and queens are present, the astrologer is also sitting there, and immediately he stands up and says that yes, this is a good muhurat for you to do it, or the childbirth has been taken place at a very nice, or the son was born or delivered by the queen at the very right. So these kind of things, even if you read some of the biographies or even the poems that have been written about the great emperors and the kings of India, you will see that these kind of things are mentioned. Now in Kama Sutra, Vatsyayana, apart from all these things, he's also indicating certain other things, and he's also very knowledgeable in his Kama Sutra. He has written very clearly about the Chaucer class also side by side, in which in our list we did not, however for him even sex was also an art, and he talks a lot thought about it also in you know, saying that yes, in schools or the places where the kings, queens or the prince, princess were sent for the education, they were supposed to be trained, and this was done through a public woman. The public woman is called as a Ganika, and you will see that he gives you the description and each and everything, and then he says that she is not bad of the society. Through her there were quite a lot of things that were taking place, and certain arts were present, and I was reading in some of the shastras which were existing as to what kind of arts were present. So, you know, flower decoration, then cooking, then eating of betel nuts, then walking in a very nice manner. What were the bodily gestures that has to be given to a princess or to a prince, the eye movement. You know, if you read, those are also the art forms, and these are given by the Ganikas. So I think this ends with us, for me to go ahead and share all the things that I have to give you. Okay, there is one more thing, and those are the 16 Kalas. So apart from the 10, we have got those Vedas, Upavedas and Shastras, Samhitas, we have seen 16 Kalas also have been discussed. Now, what are the 16 Kalas apart from the 64 Kalas? 64 Kalas were like a school given, you know, Kalas that was necessarily taken care, and it was has to be given from Guru to Sishya. Without that initiation from the side of the Guru, the student cannot acquire that kind of a knowledge. However, with these 16 Kalas, the things were very different. So let us see what these are. The 5 Kalas, like Annamaya, that is with the cereals, Pranamaya with breath, Manomaya with mind, and Vijnanamaya with knowledge, and Anandamaya with joy. These are present with every human being. So you can call these Kalas to be practical ones or applied Kalas of our daily lives. Okay, now with little effort, humans can perfect 3 more Kalas. What are they? Atish Shayini with peace. Then we have got Vipari Abhimi with love, and Sakramini with creator. You know, so these are the further stages, and these are said to be given through the blessings of the God, God as well as the Gurus. And once you are in that creative phase of writing certain things, or you're creating new words, you are, you know, coming closer to the level of the creator. That means you are reaching to that higher level also. So apart from these things, the other remaining 8 Kalas are Prabhavi, Kunthini, Vikasini, Maryadini, then Sanha Ladini, then Ahladini, Paripurna, and Swarupa Vashishta. So these are the other ones, and much has not been given. This is just too good to know for ourselves also. So anybody who has the 9th Kala besides the first 5 natural Kalas and the 3 next perfected Kalas becomes the God. So, you know, so they have gone away from human beings to the divine beings also. And they have started given. As per the scriptures, the 9th Kalas Prabhavi means kartum akurtum, that is able to do seemingly impossible tasks, which a normal person cannot do. The God is able to do it. That's the way. Like, for example, they have cited Lord Narsimha in his 9th Kala. Lord Narsimha has altogether different appearance. Okay. Now, he had a body. So, you can say that after meditation or something, you acquire some kind of a power that could be called also as a Kala. So, here they are talking about gods and goddesses, so I'm not entering into those levels at all. So try to understand that yes, ancient system of India had their own system of Kalas, and we will see apart from these Chatushth Kalas that we have got, 64 Kalas, how we are supposed to understand and appreciate the Indian Saundarya Shastra. Till then, thanks and take care. Bye.